This is the weaving project for today. This is a gorgeous design by Christine Olsen Reis, who is a wonderful, wonderful artist. This is done on a pro loom, so 27 by 27. You need 35 autumn, 15 spice, and 4 tiger lily. This pattern lends itself easily to other colors that you can play with if you want. We're going to start out with a simple weave over and under, all the way across. I like to weave with a knitting needle. It makes a tent and you can put the hook under. Pretty cool. Second row is just going to be the opposite. Over, under, all the way across. Next row is autumn again. Just simple weave again, the opposite. Under, over, under, over, all the way across. Always pack these rows down, keep them straight. And we have one more autumn. Simple weave, just do the opposite, over, under, all the way across, over, under. Thank you. Okay. So the first four rows are just simple weave. Okay. We are on row five. Row five is spice. We're gonna go over one leg. This is a whole loop. This is one leg and two leg of one loop. So we're gonna go over one leg. Then we're gonna go under four legs. One, two, three, four. Over four legs, under four legs, over and under four legs all the way across. And then you end over one leg. See this? Like you, just like here. This is what makes the pattern so nice. The next row is also spice, and we are going to go over one leg again, one leg. Then we're going to go under one leg. Then we're going to go over two legs and under all the way across. Over two, under two, over two, under two, etc. And at the end, it's going to be like this, under one leg, over one leg. Get your spice. Pack it down. Row seven is also going to be spice. Another spice. Row seven is going to be under one split and then over four legs, under four legs all the way across. Four, 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 etc. All the way across. Until you get to the last leg, which is under, just like here. Thank you. See how this nice lattice effect is starting to form? So beautiful. Okay, row 8 is going to be tiger lily. And row 8 is just over and under all the way across, like this. Over 2, excuse me, over 2, under 2, over 2, under 2, over 2, under 2, over 2, under 2. Two legs. And you're ending up over 2 like you started. We are on row 9, which is spice again. We're gonna go under 1 leg, then we're gonna go over 4, under 4, all the way across. Over 4, under 4. And we're gonna end after the last 4 under 1 leg, like the 1 leg that we started with on the other side. So pretty. We are on row 10, which is another spice. We're just gonna go under 2 legs, over all the way across. The next row is another spice. We're gonna go over 1 leg, then we're gonna go under 4, over 4, all the way across. Under 4, over 4, under 4, over 4. under the last floor and then over the last leg. One single leg, just like one single leg. Okay, the next row is going to be another tiger lily. We're gonna go one under one leg, over one leg. Then we're gonna go under two legs, over two legs, under two legs, over, all the way across. Two, 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 two. And then at the last part, we're gonna go over one leg and under one leg, just like here. Look how pretty that is. Just gorgeous. Okay, the next row is going to be another spice. Over one leg. Then we're gonna go under four legs, over, all the way across. Under four legs, over. Four, 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 four. And the last one over one. Okay, the next row is going to be another spice. You're going to go over one split, under one split. Then we're gonna go over two legs, under two legs, all the way across. Two, 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 two. And then at the end, under one leg, over one leg, like that. Okay, the next row is also going to be spice. We're going to go under one leg, and then we're going to go over fours and under fours. Four, four, four. And the last is going to be under one leg after doing all those fours. Keep packing these lines down. Okay. The next color is going to be Tiger Lily. And Tiger Lily is just going to be over two legs, under two legs, all the way across. Two, 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 etc. And over two at the end. Next color is going to be spice again. We're going to go under one leg, then we're going to go over four and under four, over four, under four, over four, under all the way across. Under one at the end, just like the beginning. Next one is going to be another spice, and it's just going to be under two, over two, under two, over two, etc. And we have another row of spice. This is gonna be over one leg, and then we're gonna go under four, over four, all the way across. Four, four. Over one at the end. Next row is going to be tiger lily. We're gonna go under one leg, over one leg, then we're gonna go under two, over two, all the way across. And at the end, we're gonna go over one and under one, like here. Some kind of a renegade thread. Okay. The next one is going to be spice again. I think I'm going to switch over to my trusty safety pin. It's gonna be easier for me to do. Okay, we're gonna go over one leg. And then we're gonna go under four. Hang on a second here. And we're gonna go under four, over four, all the way across. So one, two, three, four. Under the four, over the four, under the four, over the four, under the four. All the way across. And then over one leg at the end, just like the beginning. Let's see here. Okay. The next row is going to be spice again. And it's going to be over one leg, and then under one leg, then over and under two. all the way across. And then at the end, we're gonna go under one leg and over one leg, like here. Under one leg, over one leg. Okay. Okay, the next row is also going to be spice. We're going to go under one leg, then we're going to go over four legs, under four legs, all the way across. Over four legs, under four legs, over four, under four, over four, under four. We're going to end on under one leg, like here. Sometimes we get a little bit twisted here. That's okay. All right. If you made it this far, we're back to simple weave. Yay! Look how pretty this is. So all the rest of them are going to be autumn. So we're gonna go over two, under two legs. Twisted here. This world. Okay, another row of simple weave, just do the opposite, under. Over. Under, over. Okay, another autumn. Do the opposite. Under over. One more row to go. Let's do the opposite. Over, under. It's a little tight at the end, which is why I love using a safety pin. Some people use hair clips. See how this is here. All right. I like things to be straight. So So I'm just gonna go with my knitting needle here and just straighten these rows up a little bit more. All kinds of uses for this knitting needle. Doesn't have to be perfect because it is going to constrict because of the floats on here. Like I said, it doesn't have to be perfect because it is going to constrict when we take this off. So get your crochet hooks. I'm going to start at the top right here. Lift this loop up and grab the one next to it and pull that one under. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this loop that I just did back on the loom to keep tension. Some people use binder clips to do this. That will also work. Just pick up the next one and pull it under. Another one on. Whoops. Ooh, that is tight. Mm-hmm. There we go. All right. The simple weave is going to be tighter than the sides that do not have the simple weave. About to go around this corner here. I like to keep my thumb here because I don't want this one to pop off. I turn around the corner. Get the next one, pull it under. Around another corner. when you get back to the original loop that I looped on here to keep the tension, which is this one here, you can use that as a loop to hang with. You can also put a ring on it, or you can weave it back into this weaving piece if you don't want a loop to show. It's up to you. Pull these guys back down. Needs various amounts of straightening, but you get the general idea. How pretty is that? Look at that. That is so pretty. Here's your loop. If you want to put a ring on it, just drop the ring on like a hula hoop and then spread the loop like a shawl over your shoulders. Voila. Thank you, Christine Olsen Reis, for this pattern. It really is lovely. Thanks for watching, everybody. Have a great day.